Let us discuss first question from model number 1. So first we'll be discussing basic questions and then gradually we'll be increasing the standard of questions. By the end of this chapter, we'll make sure that you're going to solve any question from percentages. And for the purpose of better understanding, we'll be discussing all the concepts model wise so that it will be easy for you to understand and analyze the concepts. Okay, so now let us look at first question from model number 1. So first question is very simple and basic question. If 40% of 4 by 5 of 3 by 4 of a number is 48, then what is 1% of the same number? We are asked to calculate what is 1% of that number. If I need to calculate what is 1%, first I need to know what is that number. Let us calculate. 40% in terms of fraction is 2 by 5. Of is nothing but multiplication, followed by 4 by 5 into 3 by 4 of a number. But what is that number? We does not know. Let us assume the number as x. And this value is equal to 48. And we are asked to calculate what is 1% of that number. If you calculate this, 4 cancels in 4 one time. 2 into 3 is nothing but 6x divided by 5 into 5 is 25 is equal to 48. Now 48 cancels in 6 how many times? 8 times. So x is equal to 8 into 25, that is nothing but 200, which means the number is 200. So I can say that 100% is nothing but 200. If 100% is 200, my question is to find 1%. So 1% is simply 2. So I can say that answer for this question is 2. Very, very simple and basic question. Truly speaking, all this calculation is also not required. Just for the purpose of understanding, I have written everything in detail. But truly speaking, all this calculation is not required once if you are good in calculations. Okay, simple and basic question. Let us look at the next one. Next question is 0.08% of 120% of 50,000 is equal to what? Even it is very simple question, just be smart. If you observe here, percentage and two zeros gets cancelled. Similarly, percentage and two zeros gets cancelled. Now you are left out with 120, similarly 0.08 and 5. Now 5 into 120 is nothing but 600. Similarly, 600 into 0.08 is nothing but 48. So I can simply say that answer for this question is 48. Very, very simple and basic question. And don't try to calculate in detail. Just what you need is like percentage and two zeros gets cancelled. Similarly, percentage and two zeros gets cancelled. Now you're left out with 5 into 120, 600. 600 into 0.08, which is nothing but 48. That's it. Okay. Let us look at the next one. Next one is, what is 34% of 12 kilometers? Even this is very simple question. Then the purpose of asking this question is, actually if you observe here, here the options are in terms of centimeters. If you does not know how to convert kilometers to centimeters, then you may not get this answer. Okay, so let us calculate. 34% is nothing but 34 by 100 into 12 kilometers. So first I need to convert kilometers to meters. 1 kilometer is nothing but 1,000 meters. So 12 into 1,000 meters. Okay, so 12 kilometers is same as 12,000 meters. Now it is in terms of centimeters. As options are in terms of centimeters, convert this meters to centimeters. If I need to convert meter to centimeter, multiply it with 100. Now what happened? 100 and 100 gets cancelled. Now just multiply 34 into 12. So 34 into 12 is nothing but 340 plus 68. So 340 plus 68 is nothing but 408, followed by 3 zeros. So answer is nothing but 408 triple zero. which is nothing but second option. Okay, very very simple and basic question, and this was the question that was asked in CGL mains examination. And the only reason behind this question is many of the guys does not know how to convert kilometer to centimeters. If you does not know how to convert kilometer to centimeters, then obviously if you observe, options are very close, then there is a chance of losing mark. Let us look at the next one. If 120 is 20% of a number, then 120% of that number will be. Now this is very simple question. Don't forget, try to understand the question clearly. Understanding the question is really important in competitive examinations. Once if you are able to understand the question, then obviously you can solve any pattern of question. Okay, now if you look here, 120 is what? 120 is 20% of a number. So I can say that 20% of some number, but what is that number? It's not required. 20% of a number is nothing but 120. Now you are asked to find then 120% of the same number, but what is that number? Not required. So 120% of the same number is how much? If 20% is 120, 120% is what? If we observe here, 120 is nothing but for 26 times. For 20, if I do 6 times, it is 120. So similarly, 120 6 times is nothing but 720. So I can say that answer for this question is 720. Just a simple question. If you are going to read the question clearly, you will come to know that 20% is 120, then 120% is what? 720. Okay, let us look at the next one. What is 20% of 25% of 300? Already I have told you percentage of percentage calculation, how to do it faster. Okay, so do it percentage of percentage. So after first digit decimal point, after first digit decimal point. Now 2 into 2.5. 2 into 2.5 is nothing but 5%. So 5% of 300. What is 5% of 300? 5% of 300 is 15. Why? Because 10% is 30. If 10% is 30, 5% is half of that. So half of 30 is nothing but 15. Just a simple question. And don't try to do all this calculation. 20% means 20 by 100 into 25% means 25 by 100 into 300. Don't try to do all this calculation. Even if you do the calculation, you're going to get the same answer, 15. Just what you'll do is like percentage of percentage it is. So after one digit, keep a decimal point. Now this will be 2, this will be 2.5. 2 into 2.5 is 5. 5% of 300. 5% of 300 is 15. Let us look at the next one. What is 0.15% of 33 1/3% of 10,000? Very simple question. Look here, percentage, two zeros gets cancelled. Percentage, two zeros gets cancelled. Okay, now finally you are left out with 0.15 into 33 1/3. Okay, now can I write 0.15 as 15 by 100? Can I write it? Why? Because 0.15 I can write as 15 by 100 into. Now this is a mixed fraction, convert into normal fraction. 33 1/3 is same as 100 by 3. Yes or no? 100 gets cancelled. 15 cancels in 3. How many times? 5 times. So I can simply say that answer is nothing but 5. Very very simple question. Just truly speaking, even this calculation is not required if you are going to be good in calculations. This is just for the purpose of understanding. I am writing this in detail. But truly speaking, if you are good in calculations, you can directly mark answer as 5. So what I have done is percentage, 2 zeros gets cancelled. Percentage, 2 zeros gets cancelled. Then finally you are left out with 0.15 into 33 1/3. So 0.15 is 15 by 100. 33 1/3 same as 100 by 3. Calculate it, you're going to get answer as 5. Okay, let us look at the next one. 0.09% of 25% of 1200 is how much? Even this is a simple question. And look here, whatever the questions we are discussing, All these are nothing but the questions that were asked in different examinations, like bank exams, SSC exams. Why? Because even from basics also you are going to get questions. That is the reason you need to concentrate on basics also. Basics are also really important. Okay. Now look here. Percentage and two zeros gets cancelled. Now you are left out with 0.09 into 25%. Can I write 25% as 1 by 4? Why? Because 25% is nothing but 25 by 100, which is same as 1 by 4 into 12. Okay. Now if you observe here, can I write 0.09 as 9 by 100? Why? Because 0.09 is same as 9 by 100. Now if you look here, 12 cancels in 4. How many times? 3 times. 3 into 9 is 27. So 27 by 100. So 27 by 100 is nothing but 0.27. So answer is 0.27. Even this is very simple question. And look here, truly speaking, all these calculations I am going to write only just for the purpose of understanding. But truly speaking, all this calculation you should not do in examination. Just for the purpose of understanding, I am representing this. Okay, next one. What is 11 1/9% of 16 2/3% of 486? Now if you look here, even here it is percentage of percentage, but here the values are in terms of fractions, so don't try to multiply them directly. So what you will be doing is like convert this percentage values in terms of fractions. If you convert them in terms of fractions, then the calculation is going to be much easier. Look here, 11 1/9% in terms of fraction is nothing but 1/9. Okay, next, off is nothing but multiplication. 16 2/3% in terms of fraction, 1/6 into, now it is nothing but 486. Now simplify this. 486 cancels in 6 how many times? Cancels here 81 times. 81 cancels in 9 how many times? 9 times. So I can simply say that answer for this question is 9. Okay, very very simple and basic question. Just want to introduce, like, convert 11 1/9% in terms of fraction and 16 2/3% in terms of fraction and calculate it. That's it. Let us look at the next one. 20% of 45% of a number is 81. What is 40% of that number? Now if you look here, they did not ask you what is that number. They're asking you what is 40% of that number. As they're asking you what is 40% of number, calculate this answer directly. Okay, so first I will explain you a normal way to calculate. What many of the guys do is like 20%. So 20% is nothing but 20 by 100 into 45% is nothing but 45 by 100 into of a number. But what is that number? I does not know. So I'll take the number as x is equal to 81. Now they will try to simplify this. If you simplify this, what happened? 100 goes in 20, how many times? 5 times. 45 goes in 5, how many times? 9 times. 81 cancels in 9, how many times? 9 times. So I can say that x is equal to 900, which means our number is 900. If our number is 900, I can say that number is nothing but 100%. So 100% is 900. If 100% is 900, what is our question? Our question is to find 40%. So 40% is what? So 40% is nothing but 360. Why? Because 10% is 90. So 40% will be 360. But truly speaking, examination point of view, you should not do all this calculation. Why? Because already I have explained you how to calculate percentage of percentage calculation much faster. That is the reason you should not do all this thing. Look here, 20% of 45% is nothing but after one digit decimal point, after one digit decimal point. If you multiply this one, what happened? 2 into 4.5 is nothing but 9%. So 9% is equal to 81. Why? Because 20% of 45% of a number is 81. So 20% of 45% is 9%. So 9% is 81. We are asked to find what is 40%. If 9% is 81, then 40% is what? 81 cancels in 9. How many times? 9 times. So 9 into 40, that is nothing but 360. Very, very simple question. Okay. So answer for this question is 360. Just what you need to do is, like, as you know, percentage of percentage calculation, calculate percentage of percentage. When you calculate it, 20% of 45% is same as 9%. If 9% is 81, 40% is what? 40% is 360. As simple as that. Okay. Let us look at the next one. Which number is 40% less than 90% of 100? Now, if you look here, even this is simple question. But here the question is asked in an indirect way. 40% less than means, look here, what do you mean by 40% less than? 40% less than means, if actual value is 100%, 40% less than means they're asking you to calculate 60% of that number. Yes or no? 40% less meaning is, like, if actual number is 100%, then 40% less means it should be 60%. Now this is nothing but 60%. So 40% less than is same as 60%. Now what I need to do? I need to calculate 60% of 90% of 100. That's it. Nothing more than that. 60% of 90% is what? 60% of 90% is nothing but 54%. Yes or no? So 54% of 100. What is 54% of 100? 54% of 100 is nothing but 54. So I can simply say answer is nothing but 54. Very, very simple and basic question. But the only thing is, like, here the question is asked in a different manner. That is, like, indirect way. So it is saying, like, 40% less than. 40% less than means, if actual value is 100%, then 40% less than means 60%. So 40% less than meaning is 60%. So 60% of 90% of 100. 60% of 90% is 54%. 54% of 100 is what? 54% of 100 is nothing but 54. So very, very simple and basic question. Okay. So let us look at the next one. So even next one is, like, very simple. Just observe here carefully. Very, very simple question. Just observe here. So what question is saying is, like, A saves 12% of her income. If she spends 216,128, then her income is. Very, very simple and good question. Now if you look here, actually, if I am going to get my salary will be my income. In this income, I am going to have expenditure. Yes or no? In this income, I'll have expenditure and I'm going to have saving as well. Okay. Now income is always 100%. Whether you're going to get 1 lakh salary or 20,000 salary or 10,000 salary, whatever it may be, income is always 100%. If income is 100%, out of this income, we will have expenditure and we will have savings also. Similarly, what happened is, she saves 12%. Her savings are 12%, which means if savings is 12%, then expenditure should be 88%. Why? Because income is 100%. Out of 100%, she saves 12%. If savings is 12%, expenditure should be 88%. In the question, it was already mentioned, she spends. Spends means expenditure. She spends 216,128, which means expenditure is 88%. So I can say that 88% is equal to 216,128. Now, what was your question? Income. What is her income? Income is 100%. So you need to calculate what is 100%. Now, if you observe here, what actually many of the guys do is, like, they will try to calculate this. But truly speaking, if you're trying to calculate this, you're going to end up with lot of time. So never calculate. So always try to be smart. If you observe here, you have last digit as 8. Even here you have last digit as 8. Now 8 multiplied with what number you're going to get 8? If 8 is multiplied with 1, you'll get it as 8. Yes or no? Or if 8 is multiplied with 6, 8, 6 times 48, even then I can get it as 8, which means my last digit should be either 1 or 6. If my last digit is 1, 8 into 1, I will get 8. Or if my last digit is 6, 8 into 6, I will get 48. Which means our answer should have last digit either 1 or 6. And don't forget here, it is 2 zeros. Which means as we are having 2 zeros, our option should also have last 2 zeros. Okay, let us check out the option having 2 zeros at last. If you look here, I don't have 2 zeros at last. So wrong answer, I don't have 2 zeros at last, wrong answer, I have 2 zeros at last. If you observe here, I have 3 zeros here, even this is wrong answer. So you can simply say that option C is going to be my right answer. As you observe here, as I have told you, my last digit should be either 1 or 6. Now if you observe here, you are having 6 and last 2 zeros as well. My condition is going to be satisfied, so I can simply mark it as option C. And don't try to calculate. If you are trying to calculate this, what happens is like calculation is going to be complicated. Rather than calculating, just do smart work. If you do smart work, you will come to know that very simple, 88% is 216128, which means 216128 exactly cancels in 88. You are supposed to know what is 100%. As it is 100%, you are having 2 zeros at last, your answer also should have last 2 zeros. If you look here, this is wrong answer. This is wrong answer. Here you have last 2 zeros. Here you have last 2 zeros. Now what you need to do? Check for the last digit. If you check for the last digit, 8 multiplied with what? It is going to get 8. 8 multiplied with 1 or 6. Which means last digit should be either 1 or 6. You have last digit 6. So you can directly mark it as 245600. Very, very simple and basic question. Okay. Now let us look at the next question. So next, it's question number 12. So what is your 12th question? All these are like very simple and basic questions. So once if you are going to be good in your concept, then solving these questions will be very simple. Look here. So what question is saying? If the number is decreased by 25%, then the result becomes 390. Find the original number. Now already I have told you, even these type of questions are also going to come in examination. Look here, decreased by 25%. 25% in terms of fraction. 25% in terms of fraction is 1 by 4. Now when I say decreased, decrease means it should be minus. So minus, okay? Which means original number is how many parts? Original number is 4 parts. New number. Or decreased number, what it may be. New number is how many parts? New number is 3 parts. Okay. Now if you observe here, it is saying that if the number is decreased by 25%, then the result becomes 390, which means decreased number is 390. Look here, decreased number or new number is how many parts? 3 parts. So decreased number is 3 parts. So 3 parts is equal to 390. If 3 parts is 390, we are asked to find original number. Original number is how many parts? 4 parts. So 4 parts is how much? Calculate here. So 390 cancels in 3 how many times? 130 times. 130 into 4. So 130 into 4 is nothing but 520. So I can simply say that answer for this question is nothing but 520. Very, very simple and basic question. And if you have observed here, what generally many of us do is like, we will try to do it in percentage. If you are going to do it in percentage, what happened? Let us observe. If I say original number is 100%, original number is 100%, decrease it by 25%. 100%, if I decrease by 25%, now it is going to be 75%. So after decrease by 25%, the number is going to be 75%. And this value is nothing but 390. So 75% is 390. We are asked to find what is original number. Original number means 100%. So simply what you need to do, 75% is 390, then 100% is what? Then if you calculate it, 25 goes here 3 times, 25 goes here 4 times, and 390 cancels in 3, 130 times, 130 into 4, that is nothing but 520. So either you can calculate using percentage or you can calculate using parts as well. Both of them will give the same answer. Okay, calculating using percentage or calculating using parts, both of them are like same. Depending upon the percentage value, either you can use percentages concept or you can use this parts as well. Both of them will give us the same answer. But whenever you're trying to solve with parts, make sure that this numerator, either it will be increased or decreased. If the question is saying increased, then you need to add this numerator to denominator. If the question is saying decreased, then you're supposed to subtract the numerator from denominator. That is the reason in this question we have decreased. As it is decreased, I'm subtracting this numerator value from denominator. So that is the reason 4 minus 1, decrease in number is 3 parts and original number is 4 parts. Okay. Next question. If the number is decreased by 25%, then the result becomes 390. Find the original number. So we are asked to find what is the original number. Now even this question is like very simple question. First I will be saying you a normal way to calculate this question, followed by a smart way. So if you observe here, we does not know what is original number. So let us assume original number as 100%. If I assume original number as 100%, question said that the number is decreased by 25%. So decreased number will be 100 minus 25, that is 75%. So original number is 100%. When it is decreased by 25%, decreased number will be 75%. After decreasing by 25%, the number is going to become 390, which means 75% is equal to 390. We are asked to find what is the original number. So original number is nothing but 100%. So look here, 25 cancels here 3 times, 25 cancels here 4 times, 390 cancels in 3. How many times? 130 times. So 130 into 4, that is nothing but 520, which means answer for this question is 520. Very, very simple question. So either you can solve this question in this way or you can solve using fractions as well. If you're going to solve using fractions, 25% in terms of fraction is 1 by 4. When you say 1 by 4, whatever you're having in the denominator, whatever you're having in the denominator, it is nothing but original value. Yes or no? So whatever we have in denominator, this is original value. And this numerator is nothing but either incremented or decremented. Now in this question, it was said like decreased. As it is decreased, it should be negative. Why? Because if it is increment, you need to do plus. If it is decrement, you need to do minus. So look here, original number is 4 parts. Decrease in number is nothing but 4 minus 1, 3 parts. Okay, so decrease in number is 3 parts. So 3 parts is equal to 390. We are asked to find original number. Original number is 4 parts. So 4 parts is how much? So 390 cancels in 3. How many times? 130 times. So 130 into 4, that is nothing but 520, which means our original number is nothing but 520. So either you can solve them using percentage or you can solve them using fraction. But don't forget, whenever you're trying to calculate them in terms of fraction, whatever you have in the denominator, it is always original number. Now this numerator is nothing but either increment or decrement. If it is increment, you will take it as positive sign. If it is decrement, you will be taking it as negative sign. Okay. Let us look at the next one. So next question is, a number increased by 22 1/2% gives 98. The number is, which means what is the original number? Now this is increased number. We are asked to find what is the original number. Now look here, 22 1/2% in terms of fraction. We don't have exact value for 22 1/2%. So 22 1/2% can be written as 10% plus 12.5%. So 10% fraction value is 1 by 10. 12.5% fraction value is 1 by 8. So 10 and 8, LCM is nothing but 40. Now this will be 4 times and this will be 5 times. So this is going to be 9 by 40, which means 22 1/2% is 9 by 40. So from this we can say that original number is going to be 40 parts and increase in number. Increase in number means, look here, in the denominator we have 9. So you need to do plus 9. Why? Because increment will be for numerator. So increase in number will be 40 plus 9. 40 plus 9, 49 parts. So increase in number is 49 parts. Original number is nothing but 40 parts. Yes or no? When the number is increased by 20 to 1 by 2%, the number is going to be 98, which means 49 parts is equal to 98. We need original number. Original number is 40 parts. 40 parts is what? Now 49, 2 times is 98. Similarly, 42 times is going to be 80, which means our original number is going to be 80. Very, very simple question. Just what you need is like 20 to 1 by 2% is same as 9 by 40. So original number is 40. Increase in number will be 40 plus 9, 49 parts. If 49 parts is 98, 40 parts is what? That's it. Let us look at the next one. A number which when increased by 30% becomes 530. The number is. So we're asked to find what is the number, which means what is the original number. Now, either you can do option verification or you can do it using percentages or you can use using fractions as well. It's up to you. 30% in terms of fraction is 3 by 10. Yes or no? Now the question is saying increased. So this is going to be plus, which means increase in number will be 10 plus 3, that is 13 parts. So 13 parts is equal to how much? 520. Now we are asked to find original number. Original number is how many parts? Original number is 10 parts. So 10 parts is how much? So look here, 520 cancels in 13. How many times? 40 times. So 40 into 10, that is nothing but 400, which means original number is going to be 400. Very, very simple question. Now look here, either you can calculate in this way or you can do option verification as well. How to do option verification? Now in this question, all the options are nothing but original number. As these are original number, for original number, if I am going to increase 30%, for the original number, if I am going to increase 30%, I need to get the resultant value as 520. Now check the options. When you are increasing by 30%, which is going to give resultant value 520. So whatever the option going to give 520 resultant value, that is going to be an answer. Now look at first option. First option is 400. For 400, if I increase 30%, 400, 30% is 120. So 400 plus 120 is 520, which is same as our resultant number. Yes or no? So that is reason, either you can do in terms of fractions, or you can do in terms of percentage, or you can do option verifications as well. So you have several options to do this question. Okay? So it's all about common sense. Next question. A number which when increased by 41.66% becomes 3893. The number is. We're asked to find what is the original number. Look here. What is 41.66% in terms of fraction? 41.66% is nothing but 5 by 12. As it is said, increased. So this is going to be plus. So new number or incremented number will be 12 plus 5, 17 parts. So increase in number is 17 parts. Original number, denominator is 12. So original number will be 12 parts. Yes or no? Now in the question it is said that when it is increased by 41.66%, it is going to become 3893, which means 17 parts is 3893. Now we are asked to find what is the original number, that is 12 parts. Now look here, don't try to do calculation, try to be smart, that's it. Now 7, if I multiply with what number, I am going to get last digit as 3. With what number should I multiply 7 so that I am going to get last digit as 3. Now look here, 7 9 times will be 63, where last digit is going to be 3. Yes or no? Which means 7 should multiply with 9. When 7 is multiplied with 9, I can get last digit as 3. So similarly, 2 multiplied with 9, 2 9 times 18. So last digit should be 8. Here last digit is 3, so here last digit should be 8. Now check for the option showing last digit 8. Last digit 8, we have only one option. 2, 7, 4, 8. In this last digit is 7. In this last digit is 5. In this last digit is 1. So only one option having last digit 8. So you can mark answer as 2, 7, 4, 8. And look here, many of the guys, what they try to do is like they try to calculate this. You have to do calculations only whenever it is required. You are not supposed to do all the time. Okay, so just you need to be smart. Whenever the calculation is required, only then you are supposed to do calculation. If you think that calculation is really not required, then use your common sense. Use your common sense and mark the answer. Just use your common sense. With what number should I multiply 7 so that I get last digit 3? 7, 9 times 63. Similarly, 2 also multiplied with last digit 9. So 2, 9 times 18. So you have only one option last digit showing 8. So mark it the answer. Okay, let us look at the next one. When a number is increased by 20, it becomes 116% of itself. What is the number? Now look here, even this simple question, but the question is asked in a different way. So that is the reason, always read the question clearly. Look here, when a number is increased by 20, so we are trying to increase the number by 20. When I increase the number by 20, it becomes 116%. It becomes 116% of itself. It becomes 116% of itself means initially number is going to be 100%. Okay, when I increment it by 20, then what happened? It is going to become 116% of itself, which means this 20 is nothing but difference of 100% and 116%, right? So 100% and 116% difference is nothing but 16%. So 16% is equal to 20. If 16% is 20, our question is, what is the number? Which means, what is the original number? Original number is nothing but 100%. So 100% is what? So calculate here, 4 goes here 4 times and 4 goes here 5 times and 100 cancels in 4. How many times? 25 times. So 25 into 5 is nothing but 125, which means original number is going to be 125. Very, very simple question. Just understand the question. When you understand the question, we can clearly say that 16% is same as 20. If 16% is 20, we are asked to find original number. Original number is 100%. 100% is 125. So let us look at the next one. Next question is, when a number is increased by 216, it becomes 140% of itself. What is the number? Now even this is similar to whatever we have discussed earlier. When it is increased by 216, it is going to be 140% of itself, which means 100% is converted to 140%. Now what is the difference? Difference is 40%. So I can say that 40% of value is equal to 216. If 40% is 216, we are asked to find original number. Original number is 100%, yes or no? So 20 cancels here 2 times and 20 cancels here 5 times. And if you look here, 216 cancels into how many times? 108 times. Okay, so 108 into 5. So 108 into 5 is nothing but 540. So I can simply say that answer is nothing but 540. Very, very simple question. Just you need to know that when it is increased by 216, it is going to be 140% of itself, which means 100%, 140%, difference is 40%. So 40% is equal to 216. If 40% is 216, we are asked to calculate original number. 100% is what? 540. Let us look at the next one. If 85% of a number is added to 75, then the result is the number itself. The number is, even it is very, very simple question. Look here, 85% of a number added to 75, then the result is number itself. Number itself means original number is 100%, yes or no? So 85%, 100%, difference is 15%. Now this 15% value is equal to 75. If 15% is 75, we are asked to find what is the original number. So original number is 100%. 100% is what? So 75 cancels in 15. How many times? 5 times. So 5 into 100, it is nothing but 500. So So we can simply say that answer is 500. Very, very simple question. Just read the question clearly. When you read the question clearly, it is said that 85% of number is added to 75, which means when 85% of number, when I add it to 75, it is going to become number itself. Number itself means 100%, which means for 85%, if I'm adding 75, I'm getting 100%. So 85%, 100%, difference is nothing but 15%. Now this 15% is nothing but 75. If 15% is 75, what is the number? So number is 100%. 100% is nothing but 500. Okay. Next question. When 75% of a number is added to 75, the result is same number. Same number means 100%. Okay. We are asked to find what is the number. Now even this is like similar question. 75% of number, when you add 75, it is going to be same number. Same number means 100%. So look here. 100%, 75%. Difference is how much? Difference is 25%. Now this 25% difference is equal to 75. So 25% is 75. We are asked to find what is the number. So number is nothing but 100%. So 100% is what? So 75 cancels in 25. How many times? 3 times. So 3 into 100, that is nothing but 300, which means our number is 300. Very, very simple. And look here, all these are basic questions, and these are the questions that are going to come in examinations as well. Okay. Next one. The sum of two numbers is 520. So two number sum is 520. If bigger number is decreased by 4% and smaller number is increased by 12%, then the numbers obtained are equal. The number is, that is like smaller number is. We are asked to find smaller number. Even this is like a simple question. Look here, two numbers are there. One is bigger number and one is smaller number. So question is saying that bigger number plus smaller number, sum. Sum is nothing but how much? So bigger number, smaller number, sum is 520. And if you have observed the question clearly, if bigger number is decreased by 4%, let us say bigger number is 100%. If I am decreasing by 4%, 100% minus 4%, that is 96%, which means 96% of bigger number. And smaller number is increased by 12%. Smaller number is 100%. When increased by 12%, it will be 112%. Yes or no? 112%. So 112% of smaller number. Okay. So look here. When bigger number is decreased by 4% and smaller number is increased by 112%, now both the numbers obtained will be equal. So obtained numbers will be equal. As it is equal, so simply I can say that 96% of bigger number is equal to 112% of smaller number. My question is, what is the smallest number? Very simple, calculate percentage, percentage cancel, off, cancel. Now if you look here, 4 cancels here, sorry, 8 cancels here directly. 8 cancels here how many times? 8 cancels here 12 times, yes or no? Similarly, 8 cancels here how many times? 8 cancels here 14 times. Any more cancellations? 2 cancels here 6 times, 2 cancels here 7 times. So I can say that bigger number by smaller number is equal to 7 by 6. Yes or no? Why? Because 6b is equal to 7s. So bigger number by smaller number is equal to 7 by 6, which means bigger number is 7 parts and smaller number is 6 parts. So both of them combined together, 7 plus 6, how many parts? Total 13 parts. Already we know that sum is 520. So 13 parts is equal to 520. If 13 parts is 520, we can say that one part is equal to 40. If one part is 40, we need smallest number. Smallest number is 6 parts. So smallest number is going to be 6 parts. So 6 parts will be 6 into 40, which is nothing but 240. Okay. So smallest number is nothing but 240. Very, very simple question. And look here, all this calculation, truly speaking, not required. All this calculation we are representing just for the purpose of understanding. So simply 96% of biggest number is equal to 112% of smallest number. So from this we can say that bigger number to smaller number ratio is 7/6. So bigger number is 7 parts, smaller number is 6 parts. So both of them combined together 13 parts. So if 13 parts is 520, one part will be 40. We are asked to find smallest number. So smallest number is 6 parts. 6 parts will be 6 into 40, that is 240. Next question. If 60% of a number is 120 more than 20% of number, then 28% of the number is less than 33 1/3% of number by. Even this very simple question. But the thing is, like, read the questions clearly. When you read the question clearly, then you'll understand it. Once if you are going to understand it, even complicated questions looks as easy questions. Okay, look here. 60% of number is 120 more than 20% of number. Look here, 60% of number is 120 more than 20% of number, which means this 120 is nothing but difference of 60%, 20%, 60%, 20% difference is 40%, yes or no? Which means 40% is equal to 120. If 40% is 120, now what is your question? Your question is, then 28% of the number is less than 33 1/3% of number by, which means I need to know difference of 28% and 33 1/3%. What is the difference of 28% and 33 1/3%? Difference is nothing but 5 1/3%. Yes or no? If you want, you can observe it carefully. 33 1/3% minus 28% is nothing but 5 1/3%. Now, can I write this 5 1/3% as 16 3%? Why? Because this is a mixed fraction. I can write it as 16 1/3%. So simply I need to calculate 16 3%. Yes or no? So 40% is 120, then 16 3% is what? So 120 cancels in 40 three times. Now 16 3% will be 16 3 × 3. Now 3 and 3 gets cancelled. So you can simply say that answer is nothing but 16. Very, very simple question. And look here, truly speaking, examination point of view, all these are not required. Just for the purpose of understanding, I am showing all these things. But if I am going to write the examination, just understanding the question. If I understand the question, I will come to know 60%, 20% difference is 40%. 40% is equal to 120. And we are asked to find difference between 28% and 33 1/3%. 28%, 33 1/3% difference is 5 1/3%, which is same as 16 3%. If 40% is 120, then 16 3% is what? 16 3% is nothing but 16. Yes or no? So simply understand the question. Once if you're able to understand the question, you can solve these questions very easily. Okay? So with this, whatever the questions we have discussed in model number one, all these are like very simple and basic questions. Okay?